Lucifer has awakened!
Goddess in the rain. What are people like on the inside?
Inside most people, there's a feeling of being separate. Separated from everything.
And
they're not. They're part of absolutely everyone. And everything.
Everything. I'm part of this tree.
You don't believe me.
It's hard to believe that. All of that.
Well, that's because you have this spot that you can't see past. My grams and gramps had it. Spot where they were taught they were disconnected from everything.
So that's what they'd see if they could, that they're connected?
And how beautiful they really are. And that there's no need to hide or lie. And that it's possible to talk to someone without any lies, with no sarcasms. No deceptions, no exaggerations. Or any of the things that people use to confuse the truth.
I don't know a single person who does that.
Rehabilitated? Well, now let me see. You know, I don't have any idea what that means.
Well, it means you're ready to rejoin society.
I know what you think it means, Sonny. To me, it's just a made-up word. A politician's word, so that young fellas like yourself can wear a suit and a tie and have a job. What do you really want to know? Am I sorry for what I did?
Well, are you?
There's not a day goes by I don't feel regret. Not because I'm in here, because you think I should. I look back on the way I was then. A young, stupid kid who committed that terrible crime. I want to talk to him. I want to try to talk some sense to him. Tell him the way things are. But I can't. That kid's long gone. This old man is all that's left. I gotta live with that. Rehabilitated. It's just a bullshit word. So you go on and stamp your form, Sonny, and stop wasting my time. Because to tell you the truth, I don't give a shit.
On the day of my judgment, when I stand before God, and he asks me, why did I kill one of his true miracles? What am I going to say? That it was my job. It was my job.
You tell God the Father it was a kindness you done. I'm tired, boss. Tired of being on the road, lonely as a sparrow in the rain. I'm tired of never having me a buddy to be with, to tell me where we's going to, coming from, or why. Mostly I'm tired of people being ugly to each other. I'm tired of all the pain I feel and hear in the world every day. There's too much of it. It's like pieces of glass in my head. All the time. Can you understand?
I fear this quest has set in motion forces we do not yet understand. Something moves in the shadows, unseen, hidden from our sight. It will not show itself. Not yet. But every day it grows in strength. You must be careful.
believes that it is only great power that can hold evil in check. But that is not what I have found. I found it is the small things, everyday deeds of ordinary folk that keeps the darkness at bay. Simple acts of kindness and love.
You are not alone.
Are you happy?
What does happy have to do with anything?
Everything. You can live a whole lifetime without ever being awake.
Hey, Socrates. You know so much? How come you're working at a gas station?
This is a service station. We offer service. There's no higher purpose.
Than pumping gas?
Service to others. Everyone tells you what to do and what's good for you. They don't want you to find your own answers. They want you to believe theirs.
Then let me guess. You want me to believe yours?
No. I want you to stop gathering information from outside yourself and start gathering it from the inside. Take out the trash, Dan. The trash is anything that is keeping you from the only thing that matters. This moment.
Look at you. Hanging on for dear life. Afraid to fall. Well, I say, fall! You know what you're doing? No!
Do you know who you are?
I don't know what to do now.
First realization of a warrior.
What is?
Not knowing.
Anger, hatred, violence. They're really all just fear. Fear, then, not money, is the root of all evil. Chaos theory is correct, except the chaos is actually not chaotic at all, but perfectly controlled. The people that are the hardest to love are usually the ones who need it the most. There's never nothing going on. There are no ordinary moments.
You don't get what you want, you suffer. And even when you get exactly what you want, you still suffer. Because you can't hold on to it forever.
I can't think that dreams are bad.
You don't surrender your dreams. You surrender the one thing you never have and you never will. Control.
Life has just three rules.
And you already know them.
Paradox. Never in change.
Paradox.
Life is a mystery. Don't waste time trying to figure it out.
Humor.
Keep a sense of humor. Especially about yourself. It is a strength beyond all measure.
Change.
Now that nothing stays the same. The journey. Journey is what brings us happiness. Not the destination.
There's some good in this world, and it's worth fighting for. But in the end, it's only a passing thing. This shadow. Even darkness must pass. A new day will come. And when the sun shines, it'll shine out the clearer.
As Oprah Winfrey said, what you dwell on is what you become. Once you understand that humans are the ultimate adaptation machine, and you understand that the brain actually builds faster and better connections between the things that you think on, you will begin to understand that it is incredibly important to be thoughtful about what you think about. It's incredibly important to pick a direction that you want to grow in, to decide who you want to become, and then make that the center of your focus, your thoughts, your time, your energy. And if you look inward, or if you look outward, and you don't like what you see, remember what Jim Rohn said. If you don't like how things are, change it. You're not a tree. And that's the beauty. That's the beautiful thing about being a human. We are so plastic, and we can change so dramatically. We are so good at adapting that we forget. That's literally what we do. But if you can take control of that process, if you can grab a hold of it and make it your own, if you can make it your daily obsession to make the most of your potential, to pick a very specific direction, to pick an end goal, an end state, an end identity, and work your way backwards, find out the steps that you're going to need to take to get there, to execute, and have the willingness to put in the work, to have the willingness to be both the sculptor and the clay, to understand that the suffering that comes with that, of changing yourself, of making yourself into something great, is a suffering well worth it. It's a suffering that you should embrace. It's a suffering that you should run towards, because in that suffering, you can become anything you want. So start to dwell on that. Dwell on a vision of you being great. Dwell on a vision of you accomplishing your goals. Dwell on a vision of you having done this amazing thing that you want to do. Dwell on an image of you being willing to sweat and bend yourself in half and break if need to and bleed when necessary to become the vision of yourself you always knew you could become. Dwell on that, and nothing can stop you.
And the boy said, Daddy, there's a million pigeons waiting to be hooked on new religions. Hit the road, Daddy, leave your common law wife. Spread the religion of the rhythm of life. And the rhythm of life is a powerful beat. Puts a tingle in your fingers and a tingle in your feet. Rhythm in your bedroom, rhythm in the street. Yes, the rhythm of life is a powerful beat.
To feel the rhythm of